Well, I think we already have some examples of how societies can respond to what's in effect going to be a kind of energy famine in the years ahead. We have the example of Cuba, which had to respond to the loss of cheap oil from the Soviet Union back in the beginning of the 1990s. It was a very difficult time for Cuba because Cuban agriculture was heavily dependent on imported oil. So the Cuban people actually lost, on average, about 30 pounds apiece. There was widespread malnutrition, especially among children. However, the Cuban people were able to make a transition to primarily to organic agriculture. They reduced the fossil fuel inputs, and also urban agriculture, because they weren't able to transport food easily from the countryside to the city. Also, they needed more people working in the countryside because they didn't have the fuel for all of the tractors and other farm machinery. So they needed more farm laborers. With their command and control economy, they were able to accomplish all of this pretty rapidly. Now, of course, one can criticize the Cuban political system, and I think justifiably. But if we're simply looking at how they responded to the problem of energy scarcity, I think there's a lot to learn from that society. We also have a lot of very good ideas about how to feed people using fewer fossil fuel inputs by way of permaculture, biodynamic and biointensive farming and gardening. There are a lot of models out there that are being used on a relatively small scale today, but that could be expanded and replicated dramatically. Ultimately, we will need a lot more human labor in food production. In all agricultural societies throughout history, up to the present, usually 85 to 90% of the population were involved in direct production of food. Today, in the United States, it's fewer than 2% of the population. And the only way we're able to maintain that kind of regime is because we substitute fossil fuels for human labor. And it's been very efficient and cheap and easy to do that. In the future, we won't be able to do that to nearly the same extent. So I would say people who are looking for job security could look toward energy efficiency consulting, toward food production, and particularly teaching people how to grow food using permaculture and biointensive methods. Teaching people how to assess their energy consumption in their lives, not just in terms of household energy consumption, but also transportation, home heating, and so on. There's really a lot that can be done, both in terms of efficiency and also curtailment of usage. There's no question that we're headed toward a very difficult transition. This is going to be a kind of bottleneck in human history. It's going to be a very trying time. But at the same time, we human beings are extremely adaptable. We are an intelligent and an adaptable species. And if we are willing to work together, work cooperatively, and willing to change our expectations about life and who we think we are, particularly in the United States, I think we've developed the idea of person as consumer rather than citizen. And we look at the word progress as meaning an increasing availability of cheap consumer products. If we start to think of progress in more in cultural terms, of developing the resilience of community, of developing higher and more broadly accessed cultural forms of art and music and dance, and community participation, then I think we could enjoy very high levels of progress and cultural attainment in the future. But we have to change our expectations.